anywhere crazier, they wouldn't have gotten away with it. So I didn't really agree with that. They could have left that out of the Dudley Boys saying goodbye because of their promo. It was really fantastic and really heartfelt. I really felt the emotion, especially from Bubba Ray and D-Von, when D-Von said, testify one final time. But there'll always be that skepticism of how people, you know, believe this happened for whatever reason it did with the Dudley Boys. There will always be that question of what backstage politics were going on to cause the Dudley Boys to come out, resulting in them coming out announcing their retirement and saying goodbye for the final time. And there'll always be that wrestling fan that wonders whether or not we really have seen the end of the Dudley Boys. Will they come back and feud with Anderson and Gallows, somehow tie into a feud with the New Day over the tag team titles, probably a triple threat angle? Is this really it for the Dudley Boys? I think it is. I think we can get away with saying that, and there will always be that wrestling fan that will wonder whether or not they will come back just for the sake of putting people through tables like Shawn Michaels and Triple H always do all the time. Shawn Michaels, the New Age Outlaws, The Rock have done, Brock Lesnar's done, The Undertaker coming in once a year to wrestle either at WrestleMania or some major event like SummerSlam, depending on what the circumstances are and what they've allowed. Obviously, we'll probably see them making independent wrestling promotion appearances. That will probably be up in the air, too. And left out there for the Dudley Boys to do. It wouldn't surprise me none if they went wrestling for another wrestling promotion as Ric Flair did when he allegedly announced his retirement in 2008, had his final match against Shawn Michaels, and then showed up in companies like TNA and Ring of Honor just a short time after. So there's always that chance of seeing the Dudleys again outside of WWE, depending on what kind of politics we are looking at for them. So there's still a lot of questions surrounding the Dudley Boys' retirement, but I want to know what your reaction was when you heard of this. Obviously, it was reported on WWE.com hours before Raw and the fallout of SummerSlam, and with so much to cover in the fallout of SummerSlam, this was one of the top stories that should have probably been covered sooner than what I chose to cover it, because I was talking about things like Brock Lesnar's assault on Randy Orton and Shane McMahon, the return of Nikki Bella, Finn Balor's shoulder injury, putting him out for over 6 months. So, you know, there was so much to cover, so I couldn't get to really talking about the Dudley Boys sooner than what I would have liked to. So what is your thoughts? What are your thoughts on the Dudley Boys announcing the retirement? Do you think it was sufficient enough, or do you think there was room for improvement? Do you think there could have been something more done with the Dudley Boys, more in-ring time allowed for them? And what kind of confliction, if there was any, do you think actually there was backstage? What sort of politics are we looking at for the Dudley Boys retiring? Let me know what you think on Facebook at HGW Entertainment. On Twitter, you can give me a tweet at Jonathan Clark. One on YouTube, you can post something in the comments at JonathanClark22, which, by the way, if you haven't subscribed to, you can by getting in the conversation by hitting subscribe at the top of my YouTube channel and on Google+ at HGW Entertainment. Just some of the ways you can get in on the conversation, which this week revolves around the Dudley Boys saying goodbye. I don't really agree with the tagline that was used, the tagline slash headline, call it what you want, for the Dudley Boys retiring. The Dudley Boys say goodbye after a 20-year career is what WWE.com and Monday Night Raw used as the headline for this. Are they really retired? Is this it for the Dudley Boys? I think we can call it a career for them at the end of the day by the time the dust has settled and the smoke is clear, but nobody is ever going to forget the contributions of the Dudley Boys, and there's only one word left, or two words rather left, to describe how you really feel about the Dudley Boys, or left to be said about the Dudley Boys' career, and that is thank you, because the Dudley Boys deserve nothing but respect from wrestling fans, and I think they got that for 20 years. I mean, 20 years is a long time to have done something, so if you want to call it quits after 20 years, I mean, more power to you. I remember a promo done back in January or February of this year when the Dudley Boys announced that at that point in their career, they had been wrestling for over 20 years, and they would celebrate 20 years as a tag team by, say, February, which was Fastlane. Last February, they would have celebrated 20 years, and they did get to that point. So probably that's the reason why they came back for one final year with WWE, because they knew they were coming up on their 20th anniversary as a team, which I really thought they were going to win the tag team titles for celebrating it for, but they didn't. Things didn't go their way, and that was an interesting comment dropped by Bubba Ray, and some interesting tweets also dropped by both Dudley Boys leading up to their retirement. D-Von saying it was time to say goodbye, and pretty much it was just that time. Bubba Ray Dudley said, see you down the road, looking at some of these tweets, and the fans' response was, fell nothing short of having been overwhelming. So there are still a lot of questions surrounding the Dudley Boys, what sort of politics will be looked at, but regardless, what more needs to be said other than just two words, and that is thank you. Thank you so much, Dudley Boys, for an unforgettable career that will not be forgotten anytime soon. So, D-Von, you can get one more table if you want to. Put someone else through it for the sake of seeing us, letting us see you put someone through a table But what else more needs to be said? Thank you for an amazing 20-year career that will never, ever be forgotten anytime soon. Really, thank you. Seriously, I mean that. From the bottom of my heart, I think I can speak for every fan of hardcore wrestling and fans of the Dudley Boyz, regardless of where you come from, Brooklyn, New York, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, wherever you're from. I think everybody was a fan of hardcore wrestling, ECW, the Dudley Boyz, Rhino, Sandman, whatever way you want to look at it, whoever. You were a fan of wherever you come from, whatever walk of life. I think everybody was a fan of the Dudley Boyz, and what more needs to be said other than thank you. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again next week, and we'll leave it at that.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
Don't go anywhere. HEW Entertainment Radio will return with the latest news, music, interviews, discussion, and Jonathan Clark next.
When something takes place in the world of professional wrestling, you know where to go. WrestleZone.com. WrestleZone.com. Covering all the latest breaking news daily. Interactive forums where you can chat with thousands of other wrestling fans. Exclusive editorials and audio features by some of today's top wrestling superstars. Exclusive video content, weekly polls, live play-by-play coverage of every WWE and TNA pay-per-view. And now, featuring WrestleZone Radio, live with news, in-depth discussions, debates, and interviews with wrestling's top stars, past and present. When you think wrestling, think WrestleZone. WrestleZone.com.
He considers himself God's gift to wrestling, and millions of his faithful agree. With nearly 4 hours of footage and exclusive commentary and matches, this DVD chronicles Daniel's rise from Chicago's Windy City Wrestling to the Asylum in Nashville, and finally to the top of TNA. TNA Home Video presents Heaven Sent, Hell Bound, the best of Christopher Daniels. Available at most retailers and TNAWrestling.com.
Hey you, right there, the one listening to this show. While you're tuning into this broadcast or when you read the news on WrestleZone.com, are you forming opinions of it all? Or do you just agree with everything you see and hear?
If you actually have some sort of afterthought, which, by the way, is normal, we want to know what it is. There are thousands of wrestling fans just like you that simply can't hold their thoughts in either. And they let it all out in our interactive forums. You have a voice, so use it. Simply visit forums.wrestlezone.com. Don't just be active, be reactive in the official WrestleZone.com forums.
For all the latest in mixed martial arts, be sure to visit WrestleZone's sister site, SureDog.com. Complete with daily news, exclusive video, interviews, live radio broadcast, interactive forums, and the very popular Fight Finder with bios and complete match-by-match histories of your favorite fighters. SureDog is the only place you need when it comes to mixed martial arts. Visit SureDog.com today.
Hi, my name is Adam Newdelman, but I play the Phantom on the radio. I'm here to remind you that, oh, screw that, my book, Mysteries of Wrestling South, is available at finer bookstores everywhere. That stupid fake voice, I hate it. I wrote a book along with Sir Adam Kleinberg called Mysteries of Wrestling. It has the questions that you wanted answered. Why does Steve Austin hate Jeff Jarrett? Are referees really blind and stupid and dumb? Who is actually the toughest wrestler in the business outside of the ring? Hulk Hogan, The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kamala. We get down and dirty with insider facts you've never read about anywhere else. So what are you waiting for? It makes a great stocking stuffer. You're too short, you buy three of them, you get tall, you just stand on them. Mysteries of Wrestling Solved by ECW Press, written by Sir Adam Kleinberg and Adam the Phantom Newdelman. Available everywhere. It's done. The plug is done. I'm done. I didn't sell it well enough. There's naked pictures of China in there. Okay? Thank you.
Available now on DVD. John Triton is on the toughest, most important mission of his life.
I have a hostage. It's my wife.
And with everything on the line.
I gotta do something, and I gotta do it now.
Nothing and no one can stop him.
See, I tried to kill this guy twice today.
Now, see the Marine in a whole new way with the unrated version. Get more edge of your seat action, more mind-blowing explosions, more of the Marine. This unrated version features material too hot for theaters, plus special behind-the-scenes features. John Cena is the Marine. Only unrated version. Available now on DVD. Rated version also available.